Hello everyone and welcome to another video tutorial. In this video tutorial, I am going to talk about introduction to image processing. An image is worth a thousand words. We rely heavily on images for interpreting large datasets and many a times to make sense out of the world around us. In such a case, it becomes really important to understand the concept of image processing. Now let's have a look at basic terms. Digital image. When working in MATLAB, image is just an array of values, which are more formally known as pixels. Each pixel represents some more information about the particular area of image. Why do we do image processing? It is to improve the image so that it can become more suitable for human interpretation and to change the image in such a manner that it can be processed by a machine in an efficient and accurate manner. In MATLAB, the very first step in image processing is to actually read the image. For this, MATLAB has an inbuilt function imread. So let's say image is equal to inbuilt function that is imread along with the image name. Once we are done with the step 1, we can actually display the image in a figure window using another inbuilt command that is imshow. So I'll type figure comma imshow image. There is another inbuilt command imagesc which gives a very similar result to imshow. The additional advantage of using imagesc over imshow is that it displays the image on a scaled axis with the minimum value as black and maximum value as white. So let's type image sc in bracket image. Now let's try saving or writing the image. It's always a good habit of saving the final processed image. So when you have to see the result, you can directly open a saved image instead of running the program again and seeing the image. For this, we can use another inbuilt command that is imwrite. So let's type imwrite. And arguments adds previous image along with the new image name. So the previous image has been written newly as new underscore image dot png. Information about an image, like its absolute file path, size of the image, width and height of the image, can be found out using following inbuilt command, that is imfinfo. So let's type imfinfo and the image name. After hitting enter, you can see around every absolute detail regarding that image. There is another command which is used for a lot similar purpose, that is size. So let's type size and image. You can see the value, that is matrix size of the image, which is being processed. There is a crucial difference between the size of colored image, that is RGB, and grayscale images. Try to read a colored image and check its size. You will find that instead of just height and width of the image, the digit 3 is also displayed. This signifies a 3 channel, red, green, and blue. Now as we discussed earlier, uint8 is the default data type for storing images in MATLAB. There are some other types also, which are frequently used while processing the image, such as uint18, uint32, int8 double, etc. Image data can be converted from one type to another based on the type of accuracy that is required. For example, when using power law transformation, which helps in adjusting the contrast of the image, it is a good habit to use double instead of uint8. In such a scenario, we can change the data type of image using the following technique. The technique contains conversion of image into double data type as well as in uint data type. But there is one big disadvantage with this method. This can result in loss of resolution as values are truncated based on the range permitted by a specific data type. To prevent this loss, there are specific functions for image which rescale the value based on the range of type. For example, image to double with the command im to double converts input image to double type. Similarly, image to binary with the command im to bw converts the image to binary or logical data type. This type of black and white image helps in faster processing of image as there are only two values present in the image, 255 for white and 0 for black. Now let's try and extract the RGB components of image. An RGB image consists of values taken from three channels, red, green and blue. These three channels can be separated out to display image having only red component or a combination of red and green component, etc. Display the image having only red component, extract first channel of image only. Similarly, for green and blue, extract second and third channel respectively. Image processing plays a really important role in our life. This application starts in medical field with magnetic resonance imaging, X-ray imaging, gamma ray scanning, etc., and further extended to vehicle monitoring field in automated license plate reading, fingerprint matching, iris matching, moving vehicle detection, etc. In the upcoming videos, we'll discuss various operations that are going to be performed on the images. I hope you like the video. Please subscribe to our channel. Let us know what the further videos that you want us to do in the comment section below. That's it for today. I'm signing off. I'll see you in the next video.